I wonder if she's gonna overdose. Shame you don't have Max's powers. Damn, dude.
Dreamscape.
Yeah.
Chloe Price.
That's Rachel. Her fear.
Where's Frank? Her demon. Your friend? Frank? Took care of Damon. You don't need to worry about them right now. Sit.
She's in a dream. Has to be.
Sarah. Are you okay? We need to talk about what happened. I am so, so sorry. Rachel can never know.
No,
what exactly can't Rachel know? What James did. Hiring a thug. Shooting me up with him. He's a piece of shit. And I promise that Rachel can never know. That's bullshit.
Stop treating Rachel like a little child.
Rachel deserves to know what happened to you. No. She doesn't. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her. James is a lot. James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him.
I see your point. Really. I really do. Here.
And you'll take that away from her.
Right.
Forever. Don't you think the truth matters more? The truth?
What's so great about it?
What's so great about the truth, Chloe? Why are you saying all this? Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everyone's broken.
No. You're not. You're stronger than you realize. You don't know anything about me. I know Rachel needs
you. You kicked whatever it was, heroin, for a year.
The boss. I lost my father 2 years ago. How? Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and that was it. I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever. I don't know anything about addiction, but I know what it's like to be needed by someone. It gives you strength you never knew you had. Rachel needs you.
Rachel needs her family.
Exactly.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant. And talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home. Given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
Perfect mask of a family.
Even without all this shit, the Ambers are far from perfect. James is an elitist asshole, and Rose lets him walk all over her.
Maybe. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve
it. It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you?
Yeah, but you need to talk to her, too.
You lost your father.
Why can't we just not tell her about James and you be in her life? Remember your letter.
The worst mistake you ever made
was giving up Rachel.
That's what you said in your letter to her.
You read that.
You don't have to make the same mistake twice.
Right?
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother.
But you can still be a part of her life.
Exactly.
But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do.
Great, she's doing something stupid.
Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her.
Dude, this is a heroine talking.
Protected her.
Not her.
The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt.
What you see is protection.
So please,
choose a different line.
Yeah.
Tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can.
But that's just more lying to her.
Yeah, she doesn't want lied to.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I understand telling her about the father would be a bad thing because he did that out of weakness.
Don't go, Sarah.
I'm done here. Goodbye, Chloe.
And that's it? You're gonna let her just walk out?
What are you gonna do, bodily block her?
She's hopped up on fucking heroin right now. Yes. She needs a clean head to think about this shit. Not 20 minutes after she's been injected with heroin.
I don't know. Oh, they brought the nightlight.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
So what happened to Damon?
Frank took care of him, according to Sarah.
I wonder if that means
I
killed him.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later.
Hey.
Go back to sleep, kiddo. You need your rest.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Are you gonna tell her?
Okay, sweetie.
The truth. Yeah.
We'll be right outside.
It may hurt you to know it, but...
But at least you can move forward
can
from
move,
it.
Exactly.
And that really is what it is...
It's not about taking her father away from her. It's about letting her make the decision with all the
How
true
you feeling?
Facts.
Yeah.
Like I get stabbed? Doc says it'll be a 6 scar. Maybe a tattoo is in order. Fuck yeah. We never actually escaped. Did we? We've got time. All the time in the world. So, how did everything go? Rachel, I've got to tell you something.
Wow. Look at that face.
I just learned her dad ordered her biological mother killed, basically. Yeah.
But here's the thing. We don't know if he would have went through with all the evidence and burning the evidence and giving the money back. He might have not. He might not have went through with that. Damn. Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
That hatred.
Yeah.
So well portrayed.
But that's the thing. I don't think he would have went through with it.
But he did.
No, he didn't burn the evidence. He didn't give the money back. He didn't do any of what the guy...
But he was prepared to do it.
We don't know if he would have. We really do not know if he would have. I'd like to see if you went through and didn't do any of what he said to do, how things would have changed.
I don't think you can do anything.
I think you can. I can't imagine that they'd rope you into doing that.
Yeah, he definitely killed Damon.
Yeah.
Aww. Oh.
Interesting.
Family hug. Got roped into it. Damn.
So
he was accused.
Oh wow, dude, you might have fucked him.
Yeah. Looks like he's getting better.
At least he's not gonna make a stupid mistake.
And they're playing the tabletop. Damn, I wish I could have played more tabletop.
I know, I love that. That was funny.
Hey look, Nathan Prescott's got his girl going on there.
They don't look very happy.
He missed his chance. He's too shy. Finds her love of photography?
Maybe. Guess she didn't get that glowing recommendation to come back.
Oh, yeah.
From the father, though.
I wonder how different that would have been if he got told her anything. If the father would have given that recommendation.
Probably.
Poor Wills.
I think you would have alienated her, though. I want to see it again from the others.
If she learned, though, the truth.
I want to see what happened to the father.
If you lied to her and she never learned the truth, then no harm done, right?
Meh.
Only you would know.
Yeah. I wish we knew what they were saying.
Yeah.
I want to know what happened to the dad. Think he went away? What's the farewell one?
I don't know what they have left to wrap up. Maybe it's something else concerning stuff. We will have to wait and see.
I want to see what the next Life is Strange series is going to be about.
Alright. Will they
have one?
Yeah. Hey! Full head!
Yay!
There's Chloe!
Yay!
That's the Chloe we know and love. And that's what you find in the original one. Oh, nice
dragon tattoo.
Oh, that's so cool. Dude, this is awesome. I love seeing this.
Yeah. It's just depressing that it's doomed to fail.
You already know what happens to Rachel.
Yeah.
Huh. They do a very good job of storytelling.
Square Enix has always been good at that.
It's incredible.
Hell, their Final Fantasy games are just movies with interactions. Never did say what happened to the father, though.
Yeah, I didn't wrap that up. I don't think anything did.
Happened to him? Oh, well, it did show him in the
home. But I think those two are still together, but Rachel probably doesn't hang out with them anymore.
Probably
doesn't even go home.
Well, she was home at the one scene. I recognize the wallpaper.
Charlie has nothing to do with him now.
Probably.
But damn, that look she gave her was
I still don't think he would have done it. There's no way in hell he would ever stake his job, his career.
But he would have done anything to protect Rachel.
But by doing what he was... what it was implying he was ready to do would have fucked his family horribly.
Nah.
Because he would have lost his job with the DA.
Even if they found out and he went to jail, he would have protected Rachel. And that was his primary concern.
I don't think that would have protected her.
Well, no, that's what he felt would protect her. I don't think meeting her would have been a bad thing. That's why I argued so hard to keep her around. Even if you don't tell Rachel what the father did, just have the mother talk to Rachel.
I think it should have been a back talk event with the mother.
Yeah.
Instead of...
Exactly.
I mean,
I wonder what happens if you fail the back talk with Elliot in the room.
Well, if you tried to walk past him, I bet he would have just caught you and threw you back towards the room.
Probably.
Was there an option not to get the police involved?
I don't think so.
That's sad. I mean, he was really slinging some rapey vibes.
He was definitely a rapey vibe person. he suddenly just lost all his
shit. He's the type of person that starts out great, and then 5 years into the relationship, you know, you've been beat every night.
Yeah.
And you're wondering what the fuck happened.
Well, I mean, you ignore someone for so long, and they're going to get more violent,
especially
if they want something from you.
I mean, the entire game, the entire series with Chloe, you basically ignored Elliot.
Yeah, essentially.
He was just... He tried so hard
to be the calm, collected.
And you didn't give him even an inch.
I know.
I mean, you didn't even come out and say, dude, I'm not interested.
Yeah.
You could have done that instead.
Well, see, I don't know, because there was no option to, like, you could turn him down and say, no, I don't want to go with you. But because when he offered the tickets at the beginning, you could have said, nah, I don't want to go to it. And he would have said, oh, yeah, it's dumb anyway. Who would have wanted to go to that?
Right.
But at the same time, that doesn't stop him from liking you. That doesn't stop him from
pursuing you. I know. I'm saying that there's
no point.
They should have gave an option to do that.
Yeah. But would he really have, even if you said no?
It's a possibility that he wouldn't have.
I don't know.
I guess if it... As it was implying that he was a type that was a stalker.
Yeah, he would have probably just kept following you even if you had said you weren't interested.
Yeah, I mean, there is that possibility.
Because he would have held on to that sliver of hope that he thought was there, that you'd come around to him, which it wasn't.
But if you alienate someone like that, you're going to push them into a side of them that they would have otherwise never shown you.
I don't know. I think personality is a solid object. I think if you're like a certain way, eventually that's going to come out.
I think the right triggers have to be met.
Yes, of course. But as long as those triggers are met, you'll always react the same way.
I think it depends on prior things that were happening at that point. Like, yeah, after a week of the right triggers being met and each time getting more and more frustrated, eventually anyone will lose their shit. It's just a matter of how it's going to happen.
Yeah.
What's going to happen when it does.
Well, that's what I think about personality, though. I think as long as certain triggers are met the same way, you'll react the same way every time. Now, it's not likely that all those triggers are always going to be met in sequential order. And if they're not, yes, you'll react a different way. But as long as those triggers happen a certain way, in a certain sequence, you'll always react the same way after that sequence is complete.
You think even if the environment is...
But if the environment's a trigger, then it wouldn't be. You have to think, if your environment's a trigger, and if what someone says is a trigger... Maybe it's just something someone says, so it doesn't matter what environment you're in. But if you have to be in a certain environment for it to trigger, it won't trigger if you're in a different environment, even if they say that what the trigger is.
Yeah. I wonder if it's a culmination of actions that cause a person to be abusive.
Probably.
A culmination of events happen to him during their young life and their midlife.
Well, I mean, you have to look at how strongly he seemed to think that Rachel Amber was manipulating Chloe.
Yeah. I mean,
if he really believes down to his very fiber of his being that Rachel is acting all this out and Chloe's paying the price for all of this,
right,
and he really wants to protect Chloe so badly, then yeah, that's what he's going to try to do. He's going to try to turn Chloe against Rachel, and if Chloe takes Rachel's side continuously, eventually he's going to be pushed to the edge where he's like, I'm through with this. I'm not going to deal
right
with this anymore. I'm tired of trying to convince you that it's right. I'm going to make you see it.
Right.
And that's the point where he starts getting above and beyond what he should have done.
Interesting.
Very, very. I mean... there's a whole branch of study around psychology and everything like that. It's incredible. And to think that humans are that complex and we still don't know everything. I don't think we can ever know everything about psychology and how people work and how people think and how people act and react. It's just, it's not there.
I mean, a lot of times you could do the same exact things with this person over the course and they'll react differently.
As long as one trigger isn't met.
Well, even if every single event takes place over and over, eventually you're going to see something different come from that person.
Yes, because of what happens after their reaction. Because if after their reaction something happens, they might reevaluate what brought them to that point, and then those triggers might fall off and no longer trigger that reaction.
Let's see what the...
Alright. Uh-oh.
Your controller.
There we go. Alright, told Rachel the truth.
It doesn't sync up, though.
I know. There's no sync there. Attacked instead of running. I didn't know running was an option. Kind to Joyce, of course. I mean, your mom is really trying. And you gotta take into account that she's not just doing it for you. You've gotta take into account she has to do some things for herself. It's not all about you.
Well, you want her to have her life, and just as much as you want to have your own.
Yeah. Is this... Is that the only thing? Oh, hang on. Here we go. Next. There we go. Okay, the other one was part of the earlier episode.
You killed the plant with soda!
Oh, no! No! So you can't save the plant! The plant always dies! I'm sorry, plant, I didn't know!
You failed the plant.
I didn't know! Alright, accepted David's photograph, naturally. We want to try to make something good with that. Let's see. You didn't have Drew's money at the start of the day. You returned Drew's money to him. You donated Drew's money. You kept Drew's money. Now, see, I'm not sure what was the best option there. I mean, I think keeping the money might have been the best option for later down the line, but at the same time, Frank's alive, so now he can give you that 10% cut.
You played tabletop with Mikey.
Oh.
You could have you could have played tabletop!
Wait, where? What? Where was that?
You didn't visit the north.
You sparred with Drew over the pudding. And you played... You could? There was, like, no option to do anything. It was just...
You talked to the girl. You didn't talk to Mikey.
I went over to Mikey's side, and there was no option to do anything. And I think I looked at the table, and there was no option. I mean, there was only the option to look at Steph and talk with Steph.
You could have donated... $1,250 to the firefighters fund.
Intriguing. Like, did I not have any money? Oh, yeah, because I gave it all to Damon before the hospital.
Yeah.
So if I had kept the money, I could have donated to the firefighters fund. Okay, let's see. Convinced Damon that Sheldon was a snitch. Oh, wow, Rachel did have the option to meet her mother. Wow. That sequence of events...
You probably could have done things differently.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Remember, you could have used a knife on Damon.
Pulled it out. So I don't know how effective actually, that would have been to fight him.
You might have been able to get him away from the mother, though.
Yeah.
And didn't have him engage you.
Yeah.
He would have thought you were a greater threat.
Wow. So there are a lot more options to that than I gave him credit for.
Should go through and see the other side.
Yeah. We might have to do that. Damn. Probably won't record that, though. But, we will have to, wait and see from this point where we go with the farewell episode, which will come
later. I'm curious what it's going to be about.
Yeah. So. Oh, hello.
Yay.
Stuff. Thank you. That was the photos we found back in Life Isn't Strange.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh. Oh, dude, Max. Yes. This is it.
17 missed calls from Matt.
From Chloe. This is calling Rachel's phone.
Oh,
this is when the guy
shit.
Took her.
Yeah, that teacher, wasn't it?
Yeah. Wow.
Dude.
So it went to that point, Jesus. There we go. See, thanks for playing Before the Storm. Don't miss the bonus farewell episode available in the Deluxe Edition. And we will get to that. I guess whenever we get to that, you may see that as soon as this comes out, but we'll have to see when that is. All right, well, thank you for joining us for the third episode of Life is Strange Before the Storm. I'm your friendly neighborhood ninja, Sathira, and we will see you next time.
Bye.